Krishna says, you want to feed me, that's all right. You collect little flower, patram, a little leaf, whatever, not that all, any one of them. Patram, puspam, phalam, toyam, a little water. Jome bhakta prajacchati. Real thing is bhakti, love, devotion. Not that Krishna is asking you, bring volumes of luchi, puri, kachori, halwa, no. Krishna wants your love, real thing, bhaktya, jomi, bhaktya praja. Krishna is not beggar. Neither Krishna is hungry that he has come to your place to eat something. That's not the position, Krishna. Krishna wants only your love. Just like father takes the responsibility of the whole family. He works hard day and night to maintain the family. He expects only love from his wife and children. That is the impetus of economic development. Otherwise, he's earning daily thousands and lakhs of rupees. It is not that he will eat. He will eat that four chapatis, that's all. What, six annas? But he works so hard just to be satisfied that his wife, his children love. When he comes at home, he sees them very satisfied. Similarly, Krishna has expanded this family. He has become so many living entities. What is the idea? Anandamayobhyasat. Because he is Anandamay, he wants to enjoy the love exchange between the living entities. That is his purpose. Otherwise, why he has created? He wants love. But these rascals, they have forgotten that thing. They are saying, there is no God. I am God. I am India. Instead of loving God, they are becoming God. This has killed the whole situation. Therefore, Krishna comes and he wanted to re-establish that reciprocal exchange of love, which is called bhakti. You love Krishna and Krishna loves you. Krishna loves you even without your love. Otherwise, how you are eating? You cannot live even for a moment without Krishna's mercy. That's a fact. Eko bahunam vidudhati kamat. So, Krishna comes. Krishna, when he says, dharma sangasthapunarthaya, sambhavami jugayajile. This is real dharma. Dharma means dharmanta sakshat bhagavat pranita. Dharma means the what is enjoined by this law, God. What God says, that is dharma. God says, do this. That is dharma. Not that you manufacture your dharma. God says, Krishna says, manmana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji mang namaskuru sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saram. This is dharma. Anything beyond this, all nonsense. They are not dharmas. Dharma koitava, cheating, simply cheating. Therefore Bhagavad says, dharma purojjita atra koitava. All rascal nam dharma is thrown away, kicked out. This is dharma. Dharmanta sakshat bhagavat panitam. This is dharma. Therefore, here it is, same thing is confirmed. Sanusthitasya dharmasya saṅsiddhi haritosana. You are religious, that's all right. But the purpose of religion is to satisfy the Supreme Law. That is perfection. It doesn't matter because it is said, varnasama vibhagasa. Brahmana varna. He can satisfy Krishna by his tapasya, by his truthfulness, by his knowledge of the Shastras, he can preach the knowledge of the Shastra to the world. He can eat on behalf of God. Therefore, according to Vedic civilization, there is Brahman Bhojan. Brahman Bhojan means whatever a Brahmana eats, it means God eats, Krishna eats through the Brahman. Therefore, Brahman, in Vedic civilization, there is no Daridra Bhojan. There is no such word. Now they have manufactured Rifuji Bhojan, Daridra Bhojan. But the real is Brahman Vaishnava Bhojan. Because through the mouth of the Brahmana and Vaishnava, those are real Brahmans. So this is the Sangsiddhi Haritosana. You may remain a Brahmin, that's all right. Just like Arjuna was a Kshatriya. He was not a Brahmin. He was Kshatriya. He was not a sannyasi. He was a Grihastha, king. His business, he knew how to kill. So by killing, he satisfied Krishna. Sangsiddhi Haritosa. This is the whole purpose of Bhagavad Gita. He was unwilling to kill, and Krishna was inducing him. He must kill. And when he agreed to kill, then Krishna became satisfied. He became perfect. These are the evidence. The purpose is to satisfy Krishna. When he was denying to fight, that was his own satisfaction. I shall not kill my grandfather, my nephews, my brother on the other side. If they die, I shall be unhappy. So what is the use of killing them? These are all sense gratification, so-called non-violence. A devotee does not know what is violence or non-violence. He wants to satisfy Krishna. That's all. They do not know what is morality or immorality. They want to satisfy Krishna. Just like the gopis. At dead of night, they went to Krishna. This is immorality. But they did not know what is morality or immorality. They must go to Krishna. Sangsiddhi Haritosana. So, anyone, in whatever position he may be, it does not matter. Everyone should try to satisfy Krishna. Madhyaji mang namaskuru. Manvana madhvakta. Madhyaji mang namaskuru. This is perfection of life. Always think of Krishna. Manvana. Always become my devotee. Madhvakta. Always worship me. Madhyaji. Always offer your obeisances unto me. Mang namaskuru. But I have got other religions, sir. Why shall I think of you only? I have to think of Goddess Kali, otherwise I cannot eat meat. Therefore Krishna says, Sarva dharma anupadhi. This is all nonsense. Give up all this nonsense. Sarva dharma anupadhitaja mam ekam. Simply unto me. Ekam. Don't bother with other demigods. They are my servants. You are not to satisfy my servants. Of course, those are real servants, that is defined. So this is the real dharma, Sangsiddhi Haritosana. If you somewhere other can satisfy Krishna, just like Arjuna, by killing, he said killing art is not very good art. But because by killing he satisfied Krishna, Krishna gave him certificate, Bhaktosi Priyosi Me. You are my very dear friend. Because Krishna's purpose was to kill the demons. Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskitam. So Arjuna helped to kill the demons and fulfill the desire of Krishna. And therefore he became perfect by killing. So if you do anything which is sanctioned by Krishna or by his bona fide representative, that is real dharma. Sangsiddhi Haritosana. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.